This is a discussion between Glenn, a devout Roman Catholic, and myself. In this discussion, we're going to explore the state of the dead. Basically, what happens to us immediately upon death? Do we have an immortal soul, as some say, which is taken directly to heaven or to eternal damnation? Now, if you're a Christian, I want to stress this is not a salvation issue. Some people try to twist or contort this issue into something that it is not. Do not fret over this. However, I do want to show you biblically that we do not take on immortality until it is given to us. Thus, my position is that we enter a state of rest until resurrection day. My contention is that God forms us in the womb, and life begins at conception. God gives each of us the breath of life, and when we die, the breath returns to God. I believe God is all-knowing. He knows everything. All of our works and deeds are remembered. Every instance of our lives is recorded. On the last day, when Christ Jesus returns, the dead in Christ will rise, and we will receive incorruptible bodies and immortality. Those who have not accepted Christ will rise to eternal damnation. Glenn asked me to go first, so I will quickly lay out what I believe, based on Scripture, and then Glenn will make a video. We will go back and forth until the subject is covered. This is not a formal debate, but a civil discussion. There will not be a winner declared. It will be up to each individual to walk away with his or her own opinion. We have agreed that no third-party videos or comments will be allowed. So let me get started. First of all, I believe the Bible is the actual Word of God. I believe it to be God-breathed, and man wrote it under the direct influence of the Holy Spirit. I believe it from cover to cover. I also believe there are absolutely no contradictions in the Bible. When there appears to be a contradiction, I always find it is easily explained through careful study. Sometimes it requires to go back into the original language so we can see the intent of the passage. Sometimes words have two or more meanings, and sometimes a single English word is derived from several root words. The so-called contradiction is usually caused by a preconceived idea, an influence from false teachings, or a misinterpretation of Bible symbolism. So keep this in the back of your mind as we explore this subject together. We shouldn't throw our hands in the air and say the Bible is contradicting itself. Instead, let us look for the deeper meaning and see what God is really trying to teach us. Do you know the very first lie Satan told to man? It was in the Garden of Eden. Adam and Eve were told not to eat the fruit from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And the day they did, God said they would surely die. However, Satan called God a liar and told the couple they would not die. They would be immortal and be like God. So this issue of soul immortality was the very first conflict, and unfortunately, Adam and Eve chose to believe the devil. With this being said, what does the Word of God say about the state of the dead? Let us turn to the Old Testament book of Job. But man dieth and wasteth away, yea, man giveth up the ghost, and where is he? As the waters fail from the sea, and the flood decayeth and drieth up, so man lieth down and riseth not, till the heavens be no more. They shall not awake, nor be raised out of their sleep. Job is telling us we lay down into the grave, and we are not raised out of our sleep until the last day. And this is what Martha was telling us in the New Testament story of Lazarus. Jesus told the disciples that Lazarus was dead. These things said he, and after that he saith unto them, Our friend Lazarus sleepeth, but I go, that I may awake him out of sleep. Then said his disciples, Lord, if he sleep, he shall do well. Then said Jesus unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead. Now when Martha saw Jesus, she said to him, Lazarus would not have died if he had arrived earlier. Jesus saith unto her, Thy brother shall rise again. Martha saith unto him, I know he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. See, now Martha knew it. And this statement agreed with the Old Testament book of Job. Resurrection day is the last day. Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming, in which all that are in the graves shall hear his voice, and they shall come forth, they that have done good, unto the resurrection of life, and they that have done evil, unto the resurrection of damnation. And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation, even to that same time. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book. Now this is referring to the book of life. And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. The dead praise not the Lord, neither any that go down into silence. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. And this is the Father's will which hath sent me, that all which he hath given me I should lose nothing, but should raise it up again at the last day. And this is the will of him that sent me, that everyone which seeth the Son and believeth on him may have everlasting life, and I will raise him up at the last day. No man can come to me except the Father which has sent me draw him, and I will raise him up at the last day. And the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Now I'm going to leave you with this. Scripture has clearly shown we do not rise until the last day, Resurrection Day. By the time we're done, I am hoping we can all realize that we can come straight to God's Word for answers to all of our questions. We can all know He is coming soon, and although we may go asleep in the grave, we have His promise of eternal life. He is our Savior, and we know matter-of-factly we will be with Him in heaven. God bless.